The St. Francis Solanus Chapel at Quincy University has been a gem in the Gem City for over a century. When Brother Anselm Wolfe, OFM, designed the glorious church as a miniature of his masterpiece, St. Anthony of Padua Church in St. Louis. Today, the chapel, which is bigger than many parish churches in our diocese, continues to offer students at Quincy University a foretaste of heaven during the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass, as they are surrounded by dozens of images of saints, beautiful artwork, and the Eucharist.
The first thing I'm struck by is just the sheer beauty of this space. It's really a unique place in the diocese and probably in the country.
Stretching 123 feet in length, only the finest materials were used when the chapel was designed in 1910 and finished in 1912, including marble pillars, oak pews, and steel beams. The impressive stained glass windows were created by a company in St. Louis and were imported from Germany. The chapel has gone through many changes over the decades. Years of neglect during the Great Depression resulted in damage. In 1956, the chapel was redesigned using the Byzantine style, which portrays figures of Jesus, Mary, angels, and the saints in more of a heavenly theme. Father Tom Brown, OFM, one of the Franciscan friars of the university, was the creator of the changes.
He modeled it after the Church of San Apollinare in Classe in Ravenna in the north of Italy. When it was built there, it was the seat of the Roman Empire. And the church still stands today. And over there, it's built in mosaic. But here, he painted the various images on some sort of a canvas and glued them up to the wall. But it's a pretty faithful replication of what you see over in Ravenna.
One of the most decorative features of the chapel are the images of the 70 saints that encircle the chapel. With male saints on one side and female saints on the other, each saint carries a symbol pertaining to their life.
The depictions of them all always serve as a great reminder that we're all processing with them towards Christ the Savior. And they also serve as a reminder to us that if they could live a holy life, if they could be saints, then each one of us can do the same as well.
Another image that draws people's attention is a copy of the famous The Good Shepherd, a mosaic that can be found in Italy. The most striking piece of artwork, however, hits you right when you walk in, a 16-foot painting of Christ as ruler of the universe. While Quincy's venerable father, Augustine Tolton, who escaped slavery to become the nation's first black priest in Quincy, never stepped foot inside this chapel, dying in 1897, he did attend Quincy University in 1878, which at the time was called St. Francis Solanus College. Today, Father Tolton is honored with a one-of-a-kind painting in the chapel.
It's a newer addition to the chapel just a few years ago, and it was painted by Isabel Armengol Lewis. It depicts Father Tolton's first Mass, which he celebrated in St. Peter's Basilica in Rome. She didn't intend it to be housed here at the University Chapel, but it found its way here, and I think it mixes, I think, really well with the colors already present here, which I think is a great sign of providence. She painted it, as I said, a few years ago, and I think it's a great way for us to have a greater connection to Father Tolton, who not only grew up as a boy here in Quincy after he escaped from slavery in Missouri, but also attended Quincy University before going off to Rome to study in the seminary. And then he was sent back to Quincy by Rome to be a priest here. He stayed in Quincy for, I think, 3 years. And then he went up to Chicago for about 7 years before he died, and then now is buried here in Quincy.
To think of all the students who prayed inside these walls, 14 of whom became bishops throughout the United States, and several others who are now serving as priests in our diocese, this chapel at the only Catholic university in our diocese has played a major role in the history of our church and in the faith life of countless of souls who came from different walks of life and different parts of the world.
In that way, this chapel serves as, I think, a really physical reminder of the universality of the church that you wouldn't necessarily see in most parish churches in our diocese, but because of the university involvement here, I think that all just hits right home.